Good morning, everyone. Father Francis, you have indeed been all things to all people of St. Thomas, the Apostle Parish. You have been a good listener, a companion, a healer, a confidant, a brother, a father, and a friend. But perhaps more than anything else, Father, you have been and will always be priest to us. As priest, you have ministered to us in many ways. Most importantly, however, you have presided over our Eucharistic celebrations, the center of our life together, and in this role have made present the body and blood of Christ to us, so that we can be fed and nourished with the food of eternity and united with one another and with all believers throughout the world. It is in this role as presider at the Eucharist that you, Father, have revealed Christ to us in the most beautiful and in the most profound way. We pray for you, especially today, and promise to keep you always in our hearts as you begin your new journey and new life.
Thank you for joining with us today. This is Deacon Jim Stewart. Jim was my first deacon at St. Edmunds in South Philadelphia. Jim was ordained in the year 2000, and he presently works at Edmunds, but he's also the financial advisor at St. Monica's in South Philadelphia. Really appreciate you coming out, Jim. Thank you so much. Listen, this isn't the Last Supper, so don't start. There's another show after this, and there's more shows next week, you know. Let me say this to you. Being a priest is an awesome gift. And we're only on loan. That's all we are. And when God calls a person to be priest, it's for his glory, first and primary. What he allows us to do is to go to different ministries and different apostolates and share with people how he interacts in our life. But first and primary is for him. And you know, I'm very privileged to do this. I've been in 10 or 11 parishes in my life. And coming and going, it's been a great and an awesome responsibility. But it also is a great joy. And it's always about people, you know. People form the community and people form the people of God. But what Sister wrote for the introduction is important. It's always about this. We come here. So I thank you for joining with me today. I'll share more thoughts with you a little bit later. But I just want to start this off at least on a smile and not a tear. So we thank God for allowing us to come together. In your kindness, please, I ask you to pray with me for Gerald and Lord of Harrow. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we gather to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
you are and you will forever be the Lamb of God. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord, you are the joy of the angels and the saints to behold your glory. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth. And Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, amen. And let us pray. O God, in the blessing of your Son, have raised up a fallen world. Fill your faithful with holy joy. For in those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Would you please sit down now as we listen to the word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you, a just savior he is, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will extol you, O my God and King, and I bless your name forever and ever. Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. I will praise forever, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. I will praise your name forever. Up all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit. If only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give the glory and the honor to the Lord. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth. You have Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give the glory and the honor to the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Maria got me a new hat. How's that? Does that look like it fits?
Yeah.
I'll wear that in pride at the diner, I'll tell you. 15% off. I have many memories in my life. I think one of the most nice songs that I think I've ever heard in my life is Neil Diamond sang it. It had to do with the Bridges of Madison County, not the story, but the song. And the lyrics are very simple. It says, the story of my life is very plain to see. It starts the day you come, and it ends the day you leave. There is always a beginning and an end of a story. This is an end of a book, but another one is going to begin. And some of the cards that I've written to people that have wrote to me things, I said to them, I just move into this world of the unknown, but something else awaits me. And I think it's the Master. And I think he's asking me to get into the boat and to go into uncharted and deeper waters. The story of my life is not over. The story of this book ends today. But a new book in a few weeks is going to begin. And the Lord's Spirit will guide and direct me and help me as that story begins. But as I look out at you here today, there are many, many stories here at St. Thomas, and there's also stories of my former life. Jim was ordained a deacon 20 years ago when I was in South Philly. Last year week, I mentioned about going to Rome with Father Fury, my classmate, and snoring, and him getting out of bed in the middle of the night screaming and yelling and hollering. And I told him, I said, well, I might snore, but you break wind, see? Well, Jim and I were fortunate to go to Rome again in 2004 when we took the choir over. And Jim and I roomed together, and Jim never said anything about my snoring. So I always liked Jim, see. But I look at it and I see faces from my past and faces of my present. Your dad, who I buried a couple months ago, I just met that one occasion, but I felt I knew your father for years. We had a nice conversation, Raphael. He was a doctor. He died in his 90s, several weeks after I first met him. That's a great story in my life, with your dad. I see Sister Elizabeth back in here. You know, she's my dancing partner at the first Friday masses with the kids. You know, she might have bad knees, or at least they're fixed up, but she can swing pretty good now. I see Fred back there, and all the work that you did with Faust and helping the old church to be revitalized and used and appreciated. My cousins are over here, my second cousins, Paul Sandman. And Paul and Amy, I married you people some years ago. How long you married?
21 years.
God, no gray hair yet. It's amazing, see. But I remember Sean as a baby. Sean was, stand up, Sean. He was a little guy, and he was very sick as a baby, and Paul called me one night and said, we want to get him baptized. They lived in an apartment out in State Road. And Sister and I went out, and I baptized him with a cereal bowl over the kitchen sink. And it worked. Look at him now. In 1975, we adopted a family from Vietnam, the Bowie family. It was Mai and Ree, Duc, and Susie. And Mai is here with us today. Mai, stand up. Everybody see you, honey. Mai's mother and father left Vietnam, and they took two things with them. They had a statue of the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Blessed Mother, and the clothes on her back, and that's all they had. And we got them from Indiantown Gap, and my job was to take them shopping. So the day we had them set up an apartment over a little deli store. And anyhow, I was taking them shopping the next day, and her brother, Duc, was in charge of, I was pushing the cart to show them what the aisles were at the Acme. But Duc never saw a grocery store before. He had 15 boxes of pancake mix, you know, 30 boxes of Tide, you know, 15 bars of soap. I said, whoa, you don't need all that stuff. It's just a little bit at a time. That's all you need. And their daughter, Elizabeth, I had the privilege a few years ago of witnessing her wedding. Stand up, Elizabeth. Elizabeth teaches at Overbrook School for the Visually Impaired. And they have a new little baby, and the baby's name is Noah. See, Noah. You can sit down now. But I'm still very close with the Bowie family. In fact, there's two sisters, Susie and Rita. And I can remember... Just again, as a young priest, I used to take them out for car rides on Sunday afternoon, and they would wait at the window for the car to show up. And we took them every place. I took the kids skating. We did roller skating. Yeah, we did a lot of the things. And there was a story that your sister told me. I guess it was the week your dad died or your mother died. I was up at the house in North Wales, and I think it was Susie said, "Do you remember when?" And I said, what was that story? She said, the day, she said, you showed up at our house and you had stopped at Goodwill and you had a sofa and you had it tied to the top of your car and you brought it to our home. Now, I don't remember that. I said, Susie, I don't remember that. She says, we'll never forget that. Never forget that. And Mike here, Walsh, in the first pew here, your dad and my dad shared many a story with Eislinger beer and a shot of Four Roses on the porch, you know, in West Philadelphia. They were great days. I've had a great life. I really have had a great life. I've enjoyed what I do, and it's all about this mystery stuff. I don't know how none of this stuff works. They say that the most important priest in your life is the priest from your first parish. And my first pastor was a gentleman named Father Lionel. He was a Monsignor, but he never went by that. He just said, it's always Father Lionel. And I used to marvel at him at Mass on Sundays, because in those days we didn't have Eucharistic ministers and we didn't have lectors and none of that stuff. We did all the stuff ourselves. But I could remember Father Lionel, he went to every Mass on Sunday. And we had a Franciscan that helped us, Father Rene, and I did the other Masses. But Father Lionel said, you stand outside church after every Mass, even if you're not doing it. He said, you stand there. He says, because that's the time people come to your house. He said, and you're their father, and you should greet them, and you should be a part of them. It's a lesson I learned from him. He also told me, he said, when you have a parish school, he said, you go to that school often, you visit children, because they're the future of the church. Every day, you try to go to school. And he said, do all the kids' confessions. Every Friday at Queen of Peace, we did a penance service, and we did all the kids' confessions. And for those that know me now, you know me, Sister Elizabeth. I mean, just that's been a part of me. He taught me those things. But here I was, this 28-year-old, good-looking, thin priest. I was living with this old guy that smoked Captain Black, you know, and wore a tilted hat. And people loved him. And I said, hey, love me. I'm the good-looking one. I'm the new priest. Father, we want to get married, but we want Father Lionel to do the work. I said, what about me? He said, no, we don't follow Lionel. What was that about? And I could remember, he had a garden in his outside the rectory. And he would go outside at nights that he didn't have stuff in the office. And he'd have his smoke and his Captain Black and his little baseball hat tilted the side of his hat. And he had the most beautiful flowers. Most beautiful flowers. And I, as a conversation piece to one night, I said to him, Monsignor, how do you make the flowers grow so nice? I'm a city kid. We had cement flowers. That's what we had. He said, Francis, let me tell you something. He said, you have to talk nice to them. I said, talk nice to the flowers? He said, you talk nice to the flowers and you'll grow. It wasn't so much about the flowers, but if you want things to bloom in people's lives, you have to talk nice to them. Many years later, Father Lionel wound up in the old priest's home. And I used to get down Friday nights and have dinner with him, you know, at the home. And they had a holy hour for the priest, and I would get down there on Friday nights once a month and have dinner. And as he grew a little bit older in life, his memory started to fade, and he started to have a little Alzheimer's and dementia. And I remember one time I walked into his room at the villa, and I banged on the door, and he looked up at me, and he said, do I know you? I said, I was the best parish priest you ever had. He said, I don't know who you are. And I said to him, you're the priest that taught me to talk nice to the flowers. And he came back and he said, oh, Francis, how you doing? Come on and sit down. Tell me how you're doing. A couple months before he died, he wrote me a letter. He had the most beautiful handwriting. It was absolutely gorgeous handwriting. He was really into this Palmer method and took such pride in his writing. And he wrote me a letter just about his life as a priest. And he encouraged me to continue to try to live the life that God gave me as a gift, to be faithful to the basic stuff. Rosary, bless a mother, adoration, and time with people, and how you treat them. I don't know where this is coming from, so bear with me. But anyhow, at the end of the letter, and he just signed it, the priest that taught you to talk nice to the flowers. I treasured that letter for years and often remembered it. And so this stage of my life is at least shutting down. I've lived in some wonderful parishes. I've lived in some challenging parishes. But I never forgot what Father Lionel told me. You stand outside church, you visit children, you do the sacraments, you talk nice to people.
And the rest is in God's hands. And there's blessing in that. I can't say enough about you as parish, the community, supporting me and helping me and everything else. Someone asked me the other day, said, how come two priests are taking your place? And you did it all. I said, well, I didn't quite do it all. I said, yes, you did. I said, no. Well, how'd you get it done? I said, Sister Nicoletta. Where's she at? Get her in here. Let me tell you about Sister. Sister was the principal of Annunciation in Harrodstown 25 years ago. And I was only there 19 months. And what happened was they called me one day and they said, they're going to make you be a pastor. I said, oh, I don't want that job. See? Said, you got to be a pastor. So her time as principal was up. And I said to her, listen, Nikki, what are you going to do the next trip? She says, I don't know, probably some other school or something. I said, I got a great idea. She says, what's that? I says, why don't you come and work in the city with me? She said, you kidding me? I said, no. So we got her apartment over a lottery store. And one day the lottery store was shot up because the mob was involved with the lottery tickets downstairs. And the day that somebody was being going up to the federal courthouse and they came out of their house around the corner and got blown away in the sidewalk. Just a normal day in the life of life in South Philadelphia. But we were there 9 years. It was great. Good time. And then, of course, they sent me to Fishtown. And I didn't want to go there either, you know. So, in fact, what they did was they were pulling me out that they didn't have a place for me to go. And Fishtown came up. So one afternoon, she and I drove up to Fishtown. And we're walking around the neighborhood, look at the church. I says, this will work, you know, this is great. So we were there for, I was there 7. She stayed two more years after me. And the people that they sent in after me were crazy. I mean, they were really nuts. They couldn't handle anything. And the diocese finally had to take them out. And Bishop Senior actually came to her and said, would you run the parish? How about Nikki running the parish? And then when John was here for a couple years, and then John got sick and left, and I brought Sister out. Sister didn't have any gray hair when I first met her. Yeah. Now she's pure white, see. But she and I have been friends for 27 years. We go back a long way, her family, my family. I buried her mom and dad. I married her brothers. I've christened some of her nieces and nephews. So she's been a great friend for me. Why do I look so good? Because Sister always made me look good. And she said her job was always the stage crew. Really, to be in the background, to make everything else work well. So help me with the baptisms and doing the paperwork for the weddings and typing up forms and doing all this stuff, getting the list in the hospital, taking me around, showing me where I'm supposed to go to nursing homes, all the other business. She's a dear friend, and she's been a great asset to the church. But she, too, is going to move on, you know, not because she doesn't want to stay, just because it's a better thing. You know, you bring a new administration in, you know, they clean house and do all the other business, and it's better for her, you know. So she's going to take off, I think, for a couple months before she starts looking for something else. It's, don't work full time. You know, don't do that. I said, you're too old for that. You know, don't do it. I said, and every Tuesday, come up to Kutztown and get that chicken at Wegmans. And come on up and have dinner. That's what we'll do. But she's been a help and a support to Maria and Colleen over here for CCD. Colleen is down here. So there she is right there. And certainly for John for school. I said, it's been a great story. It really is. I love what I do. I absolutely love what I do. But my life, I know, is unfolding into eternity. And it's just time to move on to this because the stir in my heart says, listen, there's something else that the Master wants me to do. As I said at the beginning, a priest is a priest not for a parish or a neighborhood. A priest is the father figure for a family. That's who we are. But the priest is first and primarily for the glory of Jesus Christ. You know, and before he sends you to any parish, it's the movement of his grace in your heart that says to you, I want you to come and walk with me. And so that's what this is about. It's about the walk with him. What the priest does in the parish is he shares with other people how God's working in his life. And I know people get upset when there's change. You know, it's just, I remember when I was installed here 9 years ago, the Fishtowners came out, and they don't mince any words, let me tell you something. And Jane Kozel, one of the parishioners there, Bishop McIntyre's here, says, "Well, I hope you forgive Cardinal Regali for sending Father Francis to St. Thomas." And Jane stands up and says, "No, we're not going to forgive him." See? Calm down, Jane, just calm down. When Jesus rose from the dead, they didn't recognize him because he looked different. And the same thing happens in a parish. When a new priest comes, they don't recognize it was the old priest because there's something different about him. But it's the same Jesus that is preached, nourishing, and sustaining the people of God. And in the Lord's providence, these other priests are coming here not to change anything, but just to continue the legacy and to deepen the experience of the good Lord in lives. I will be forever grateful in my life, eternally grateful, for the gift that is given to me. And I don't know why God chose me to do this. I mean, I'm not the smartest apple in the bushel, but God asked me to do it. But I always remember what my first priest, Father Lionel, told me. He said, "If you talk nice to the flowers, they will grow." You know something? It works. I pray for you that whoever takes my place will talk nice to you so that your life in our Lord Jesus will be enriched and you will grow more deeply in his image and likeness. Bless you all. If we could stand now and we'll profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in the one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, and God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Him all things were made, and for us men and our salvation came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. And for our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. It's again in the third day in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into the heavens and sits at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life. Precedes the Father. The Father and the Son is adored and glorified. Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, forgiveness of sins and the resurrection. In this season, on this day, we call your presence on St. Thomas the Apostle community as it gathers in memory and hope to thank and to bless the priests that have served here at the conclusion of my pastoral active ministry.
In thanksgiving for the early promptings of the Spirit that stirred Father's heart to consider this calling, in praise for the vision that led him through long years of service as a minister of your word and Eucharist, we pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for the graces you gave him to carry out the work to which you called him, for the courage and support needed to make real the love of Jesus by word and deed, we pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for the seeds Father sowed, planted, and watered during his ministry, bearing fruit seen and unseen, we pray to the Lord. That all who gather at this table find in their faith the strength to meet daily challenges, we pray to the Lord. For the sick in our parish community and those listed in our bulletin, that they find solace in their suffering, we pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, especially Vincent Kane, Dolores O'Donohue, that they experience the risen Jesus, we pray to the Lord. Our times are in your hands, O God. Bless Father Francis in this new season of his life and this new chapter in his calling, that his remaining years may be full and fruitful, and assure him of his place among those who have witnessed to your truth and lived out your love, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Sister Nicoletta, could you please come down here, please, before you run off? Maria wants to see you. Sister, come on down. Come on down, please. Come on, Nikki, you're messing the program up. Brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours would be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. You called us from darkness to live in the beauty of your light. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you this day and every day and night of our lives as we pray the prayer of endless praise.
Hosanna in the highest.
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. And make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he broke the bread and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Jesus. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me." Jesus, my Lord, thank you. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O death, O Lord, until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Nelson, our Bishop, his assistant bishops, and all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, the glorious martyrs, our patrons Thomas and Michael and Catherine of Siena, and all of the angels and saints who have been pleasing to you throughout all the ages, that we too might merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and forever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Would you please stand with us now? At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we might be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, and my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen." The peace and love of our Lord be with you always.
Jim is a little container rose in the community chapter.
Yeah, I do. It's a little gold thing that they're afraid right now. Would you bring it over to me, please?
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
your body and your blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring us judgment and condemnation. Through your loving mercy, be for us protection of body, mind, and soul, and a healing remedy for all of us on our way to everlasting life with you. And so behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the whole world. And blessed are those who are called here to the supper of the Lamb. But Lord, I am not worthy. Come under my roof. And I say the word. In the body of Christ, keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Before God, where
Spirits. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and hope. To thee we cry, for banished children of Eve. The Son of our sighs, mourning, weeping in the valley of tears. Turn thy most gracious heavenly faith and eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, the sweet Virgin Mary. Pray for us, Holy Mother of God, may we your promise.
Not so fast, Father. We got you this time, and I think I can do this. Father Francis, your ministries would like to give you a little something to remember you by when you leave St. Thomas. But first, as Sister said, you've been all things to all people, as you like to call us, your people, not only here at St. Thomas for 9 years, but at all the parishes and communities you served in for your wonderful 47 years as a priest. So many of your former parishioners would come and visit you, and that tells you how special and loved you are. You came to us at a time when our parish was starting to flourish, and you took it to an even greater level. As our former pastor, Father Williams, said before he left, he is just what this parish needs to come alive. And boy, did we ever come alive. Your homilies were filled with stories about life, some sad, but mostly funny, that made us laugh. They were things we could identify with and always ended with how the readings related to the stories of our everyday life. You talk to us, not at us. Since you came here, we've gone through snowstorms, hurricanes, power outages, a papal visit, and a great Eagle Super Bowl win that we'll always cherish, especially when you joined us in singing Fly Eagles Fly at the end of Mass on the day of the Super Bowl, and I think it worked. Most recently, you had to lead us through this awful pandemic and the racial injustice and unrest. But no matter what, you've always been able to calm our fears and make us feel a little better just by your voice, even through your tears sometimes. Your YouTube daily meditations and weekly masses helped so many of us, and people are now calling you the latest YouTube sensation. And everybody wants to be your friend on Facebook. God bless you as you take your new path in life. Enjoy it, embrace it. May you be proud of the work you've done, the person you are, and the difference you have made, and know that you are loved, admired, respected, and will be greatly missed. Will Paula Fratterola come up, please?
Father, each ministry would like to give a few little words.
Okay. Are they staying for dinner?
They are. For cookies.
Hi, Father.
Hi, Paul.
My husband Albert and I are representing the St. Thomas's marriage preparation team, known as the Pre-Cana team, so named commemorating Jesus' first miracle at the wedding feast of Cana. In that vein, our team presents to you, Father, a bottle of water, and when you're finished that, a bottle of wine for your enjoyment. So, you're welcome. May God pour out his overflowing blessings to you each day of your retirement. You deserve it. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ann Deersing, and I represent the fantastic volunteers of the Caring and Sharing Ministry. And if you're familiar at all with Caring and Sharing, that you know that we do, I don't know, 12 to 15 different activities throughout the year. Some are one-time things like collecting turkeys or the Giving Tree. Some are year-round. So I had quite a selection here to choose from as far as a parting gift. But while I could have chosen a canned good or a meager meal or a casserole or a turkey or a sock or blanket, any of that kind of stuff wrapped up as a Christmas present, our gift to Father Francis is a gift card to Giant for both perishable and non-perishable foods. And I know they have Giants in Kutztown.
There is.
As well as a pair of suspenders. Why the suspenders, you might ask? Well, the suspenders are because Father has supported all of our ministry's many activities through over the years. So thank you, Father, for caring and sharing. Okay.
Hi, I'm Kevin Kelly, and I'm here on behalf of Carol Zalapsky, the leader of our adult faith program, who couldn't be with us today. Over your 9 years here, Father, there have been over 50 adult faith programs that you've supported, and several hundred different parishioners who have attended them. And so on behalf of all of them, I make this presentation to you today. Last year, you might recall, Carol and I asked you about doing something a little different for the Lenten study than was normal. So we reached out to a new kind of study. It was called Walking with God Through the Desert, if you happen to take part of that. And Father came one evening. He came several evenings, but on this one evening, the lesson was focused on Genesis 21. When Hagar and her son Ishmael were banished and at the point of death took shelter under the shade of a particular tree. And in 1 Kings 21, Elijah, when threatened by Queen Jezebel, also went to Beersheba and took shade under that same tree. The tree is known as the broom tree, and it gives a unique sort of shade in the desert. It's a very tough tree to grow in the desert. It gives shade, not like a full leaf tree, but like a netting or screen would give you shade. And the lesson of the broom tree is that God always provides just enough for what we need. And that struck Father in such a way that for almost every day since that study, when he sees me, he says, "We need a broom tree." And so, Father, for your home in Kutztown, we present you with a real broom tree and hope that God continues to provide for you just enough. Thank you.
Okay, I'm Colleen named Caro, and I'm here to represent the PrEP program, aka CCD, and this is from all of our catechists. During the time that Father has been coming over to the PrEP program the last couple of years, and he's been talking about retiring, he often told us that he was going to teach CCD in his retired years. So our PrEP teachers would not leave you abandoned here, Father. We have created something for you to help you. So, we are giving you a catechist supply bin today. Look inside for guidance when you lose your way. For sticking to the topic or organizing stuff, some tape, glue, sticky notes, and files will be enough. When the kids are on their best behavior and know their facts and prayers, you'll need some treats and stickers to show them that you care. When little knees are scraped or little fingers bleed, some band-aids will bring comfort to fill a basic need. When at a loss for lessons, resort to coloring pages. You'll be surprised how much they'll learn, and you'll still earn the same wages. Your health and safety must come first. So use these new supplies to wash your hands and guard your face and keep your glasses on your eyes. And after class, when you get home to put your feet up high, these little pills will help you forget your aching head and eyes. We wish you the best. We'll miss you a lot. And we are so grateful for all you have done. God bless, be safe. And we'll pray for you in the name of the Father, Spirit, and Son.
Thank you so much. And there's a funny story about the coloring. I'll give it to you real quick, because I know you're going to have to go to the bathroom soon.
When I was at St. Edmunds in South Philly, I had to teach CCD on Sundays. So we only had about seven or eight kids. You know, I went through my Baltimore catechism like 3 weeks, you know, and I thought, what am I going to do the fourth week? You know, we did the sacraments, did the prayer, everything else. So I called sister up. She was at Harrodtown. I said, "Nikki, I'm in trouble." She said, "What's the matter?" I said, "I got seven kids. I got nothing to talk about." She said, "Color. Color." I said, "Color what?" She said, "Anything." She said, I said, "Can you get me some coloring stuff that I can color the kids with?" She ran all this stuff on, like Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, the Last Supper, all the business. I had a great CCD class for 2 years because all we did was color. So they're going to come in handy.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Greg Chestnut. I am the committee chair of Boy Scout Troop 154 here at St. Thomas. We have been in ministry at St. Thomas since 1970. So this will be our 50th anniversary. With me today is my son, Patrick, one of our scouts. We just wanted to thank Father Francis for his support and leadership with the scouts. It's been a great time being here, working with you, doing this. And we have a small gift for you so that you can continue to be a light of the world.
Oh, thank you, Greg. Oh.
Dancing part. Yeah. I'm Sister Elizabeth. I'm representing the school for Mr. Keeley and the teachers and the children. We have some of the children here. I wanted to thank both Father Francis and Sister Nicoletta for their support in school. They were really wonderful. And I was just thinking, was that a lantern he gave you? You know, to tell you the difference of what Father Francis does as opposed to some of the other priests that I've heard, no offense to them. His homily yesterday was about a lighthouse. And he said, you have to build the lighthouse so that it's high up, but you have to have a base. And the base is Jesus and prayer and the rosary and everything. So, Father, you've been a great base and a great support for us in helping us to see that Jesus is our light. Now, if you saw the picture out there, you saw me dancing. And I was trying to think of a way to, every Friday, I'd be over here playing guitar. And I'd say to Mrs. Mack, please don't have Father call me down. Because he'd think of something off the top of his head. And he'd say, sister, come over here. We're going to do the mummers. We're going to do a square dance. And so one of the things he did was, all you need is love. So, Father, you and me, the last time, here we go. You're going to hang this up at your new house and don't climb the ladder. Last time he climbed the ladder, if you remember, he broke his leg or whatever he did. So, all you need is love, love.
Dear Father Francis, in your 9 years at St. Thomas, more than 3,000 young parishioners represented St. Thomas the Apostle Parish and you in their varied CYO activities. They did so with pride and ability, being led by competent, caring coaches. We have a few of those boys and girls and a few of coaches that I saw here. We hope that you will remember the CYO members in your prayers going forward, as the CYO will do the same for you. Thank you very much.
I'm Frank Lester. Father, on behalf of the Friends of Old St. Thomas, we thank you for your outstanding support of us over the years here. We wish you a long and enjoyable retirement. And this is a reminder of your Friends of Old St. Thomas.
Thank you, Fred.
Last but not least, I'm Mary Kay Dragon, and I'm part of the bereavement committee headed up by Joanne Starr. She couldn't be here, so she asked me to read a few of her words to Father about the bereavement committee, that we are so thankful for all of the work that you have done in the most difficult times with the families who have suffered a loss. And St. Thomas, your masses have been a beautiful comfort for all who have greatly missed. We will all gratefully miss you. And I have a little. A little pillow with his initial on it so that he can rest his weary head after all of these wonderful years and all the trials and tribulations we've put him through.
Thanks, everybody.
One more.
I'm sorry.
Is there anyone here from Divine Mercy? No?
Hi, I'm Teresa Santilleri, and I represent the Respect Life Committee. And I just want to thank Father so much for all his support. We're so grateful for his wonderful sermons that he gave on the dignity of all human life, his prayers that he sent us off to the March for Life with, And, you know, his great handing out of bottles for Mother's Home, we raised like almost $10,000 when Father was out there handing out the bottles. So that kind of support goes a long, long way. We really appreciate it. But I just want to say that the thing I remember most about Father Francis is how he prayed for us. And, you know, many times, whether you would come into this church early or late or in the middle of the day, you would see Father right there with his rosary beads in his hand before the Eucharistic face of Jesus, praying for us, praying for his fellow priests, praying for the church. And we ask Father to please continue to pray for us as we will continue to pray for him. So thank you very much, Father. With a grateful heart, we send you off into retirement, but you're a priest forever, Father. So we're counting on you to do the good work for us because we sure need it. Thank you.
I promise, this is the last one. My name's Annette Steger, and I'm from the music ministry. And anyone that knows Father knows he loves Amazon, and he especially loves, I can't say it too loud, Alexa. So Maria and I walked in one day, and Alexa was playing away, and she looked at me, I looked at her, and she said, oh my God, am I losing my job? So to remind you of the music ministry, we have some homemade CDs, and also a gift card. Gift card from Amazon. You can get as much Amazon music as you want, or Amazon gifts.
Thank you so much. God bless you all. Could you please stand now and we'll... Jim Shields.
Father Francis, so many times over the past 9 years, you have blessed and invited us to bless with you. We now join together to bless you, Father Francis. Would you please extend your hand? May the God of strength be with you, holding you in strong fingered hands, and may you be the sacrament of his strength to those whose hands you hold. May the blessing of strength be on you. May the God of gentleness be with you, caressing you with sunlight and rain and wind. May his tenderness shine through you to warm all who are hurt and lonely. May the blessing of gentleness be with you. May the God of mercy and compassion be with you, holding you close when you are weary and hurt and alone, when there is rain in your heart. And may you be the warm hands and warm eyes of compassion for your friends when they reach out to you in need. May the blessing of mercy and compassion be on you.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. God bless you.
Wait, we're not done yet.
May the God of patience be with you, waiting for you with outstretched arms, and may his patience with you, with all the young who fall from small heights and the old who fall from greater heights be your patience. May the blessing of patience be on you. May the God of peace be with you, stilling the heart that hammers with fear or doubt or confusion. And may your peace, the warm mantle of your peace, cover those who are troubled or anxious. May the blessing of peace be on you. And may the true God be within you, drawing you ever nearer. May the blessing of this family community of St. Thomas the Apostle arise from within us, radiate around you, and remain with you forever. Amen.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. And may God watch over and bless you and keep you safe. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go forth the Mass again.
Thanks be to God. God bless you all. I will always treasure the gift of your friendship and love. Bless you.
Praise the Lord.
every gift you send.